Okay, 39 says you have a boat. Here's your boat. From here to here is 24 degrees and 50 seconds. And there's the cliff. So they want to know this one. How high is the cliff? Okay, so we've got to imagine like we're standing here, so we need to know this one, right? That would be opposite. And we have the adjacent. So, and we have the degrees. So we would use tan. And we can put in the tan of 24, 50. Equals opposite, we don't know, over adjacent. So we just take this and multiply it by 2700. So I'm gonna guess that we figured this out in class the other day, but if it just depends on your calculator. Some calculators are okay with the missing minutes in between, but some aren't. So if you have to put it in, you have to put it in. If not, then you have to do 50 divided by 60 to get it, but let's try it. So 24 degrees. Oh, this is actually minutes. Oops, this is seconds. If you do this, you'll get the 0.83333. So you just add that to 24. So that's the degrees. So you can do the tan of 24.8333 also. Does it say to the nearest foot? So I got 12, 4, 9. Okay, next one is B. So you gotta look at what you have. So remember A, B, C, A, B, C. So we have a capital B, which is 12.8 degrees. We have a C, which is this. And we have a B, which is this. So which would we use? The law of sine or law of cosine? Remember that when we have a whole set, we use the law of sine, right? So we go the sine of B over B equals the sine of C over C, so that we can figure out the little c. And then we'll just flip them around so that we have the little c on the top. And then we multiply by this. I got 156.8. Okay, we can figure out this guy by doing 180 minus 112.6 minus 12.8. So I get 54.6. And then we can do this. Just depends, I think, on what numbers you use, if you use the sign of A or C or whatever, but should be close. And that's it.